हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द कोर्स ऑफ मटेरियल साइंस एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस। एंड इन दिस कोर्स वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, वी आर इन मॉड्यूल 3 एंड हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कास्टिंग प्रोसेस। सो फार वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट मोल्ड मेकिंग, अबाउट पैटर्न मेकिंग ओनली। नाउ फ्रॉम दिस लेक्चर एंड द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट मोल्ड एंड मोल्ड मेकिंग। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर विथ लेक्चर ऑब्जेक्टिव। The main lecture objective of this lecture is to introspect about mold cavity, mold and process of mold making. And next we will know about different kind of molding sand and what are the properties of the molding sand that is required for sand molding, that we will know. So first, what is mold and what is mold cavity? So a pattern, so we have studied about pattern. So when a pattern is placed in a box, and if the box is filled with the sand around the pattern, and that sand is compacted, and that after compaction that of that sand, the pattern is removed from the box. Now this box is known as mold, and the material which is used, the cavity which is there due to the position of the pattern, so for that a cavity will be formed in the place of pattern. That cavity is known as mold cavity, and the sand which is used for molding is known as molding sand. And the this mold consists of two part. The upper part is known as drag, upper part is known as cope, and the lower part is known as drag. And this drag and cope and drag, these two box together, the whole setup is known as flux. So these box are known as flux. Now when the flux which is on the top, that is called your cope, and the which is in the lower position, that is called drag. Now in between cope and drag, the line between cope and drag is known as parting line. And in some cases if the job is really big, at that time, or for larger pattern or for larger casting, what is done, another part that is placed in the middle of cope and drag, that is called cheek. So these are the part of the of a molding box. So whole molding box or whole mold is that box where the molding is done is known as flux. Okay, so now in the flux, the top portion is called cope, the bottom portion is called drag, and in between, if there is some other part, that other part is known as cheeks. Now what are molding sand? Molding sands are nothing but it's the general silica sand that can be found in nature. Okay, so the origin of the sand, from where we can found the sand? The sand can be found from riverbed, sea, lake, or desert. These are the natural sand. Okay, so simple natural sand is used in the molding, that is called molding sand. But not only the natural sand, along with natural sand, some amount of water, clay, and some clay binder adhesive, and some other additive material have been added to this molding sand, so that it can gain a property. It can gain some property that by virtue of that property, mold cavity can form, retain, and the complete casting, our desired product can be made. So that much strength and that much hardness should be there in the mold cavity. So that is given by adding molding sand along with clay, water, some binders, and some other additive. These additive, these there are various, and as we know, there are various type of molding sand that is used for various purpose. And these types of the molding sands are based on mainly the property they give or the specific property they give for specific operation. So we will see about the various types of molding sand now. So first there is green sand. Green sand, what is green sand? Green sand is the sand when it is mixed with the moisture or moist sand. Green sand can be also called moist sand. That means the loose sand which can be natural, loose or natural silica sand which can be found in nature, that silica sand when it is added with the 55% water and 15 to 30% of clay, at that time what happened? At that time that sand gained some bonding. Okay, so now when we compact that sand which we use for molding is green sand. Okay, now this green sand is rammed. When it is rammed or when it is forced or when it is compacted, it gives a temporarily solid structure, and that solid structure gives us the mold cavity. So for general purpose mold making, the main content is green sand. So what is green sand? Green sand is nothing but moist sand. It is the moist sand. So green sand contains 5% of water and 15 to 30% of clay. Now another sand is there. Now another type of sand, that is dry sand. Whenever this mold sand is become dry because of loss of moisture. So how the loss of moisture occurs? Whenever after the mold making has been done, what will happen? Due to atmosphere, the moisture content in the sand will evaporate, and that moisture content, that evaporation of that moisture content converts the green sand to dry sand. And now this dry sand possess greater strength, and this dry sand possess greater strength along with greater thermal stability. Now oil or molasses sand. So when the sand is used, along with some oil binders or molasses binders are used in case of molasses sand. And molasses sand, this type of sand used for integrate, means complex shape, small thin section and accurate casting. So only for that this type of sand is used. Here along with clay some other oil, synthetic binders has been used, and some non-ferrous gears can be cast by using this sand. So more accurate shape can be casted by using oil or molasses sand. Now the type of sand is facing sand. So facing sand is nothing but it's a fresh and specially prepared sand. So it is placed, this facing sand is placed at the wall of the mold cavity. Okay, so it comes, the facing sand comes direct contact with the molten metal. So this facing sand should possess some improved properties as compared to ordinary sand, means in the wall of the molten metal, the sand which contact with the molten metal, those sand should have very fine structure, because depending on the properties of those sand, the surface finish of the casting will occur. So now to get better surface finish in the casting, what we need to do? We need to give the good or improved property sand in the face of the mold cavity. So that's why it is called facing sand. So mainly it also and this facing sand reduce the total cost. Next, backing sand. These facing sands are backed up by your backing sand. So backing sand does not come into contact with the pattern, and it is black in color. Okay, backing sand is mainly black in color, so it is also called black sand. Now sharp sand. Sharp sand need not mean that that it is very sharp, but it means that sharp sand means that the sand which has free from bonding, means the loose sand or sharp sand, this is also called loose sand. So sharp sand means there is no bonding in the sand. System sand, it is a special type of sand which is used in mechanical sand preparation and handling system. And heap sand, when the sand is put on the floor as a heap, and heap when it is prepared for use, that means at the starting of the casting, the sand is coming from the heap. Okay, some in some place or in floor there is some heap of a sand is there. So from that, by using shovel we just put water to the sand, and then we just mix up the sand. So now this at the very first stage the sand is known as heap sand. Now we will see about some property, which are those properties of the molding sand. So what are the properties that are required for the molding sand, that we will know. So depending on these properties of the molding sand, our casting quality will be changing. So now for better casting quality, better property should be there, better property of the molding sand should be there. Now in next few slide we will see about what are the required property to be a molding sand or to be a molding material. So if the molding material should be, first the molding material should be flowable, or flowability should be there in the molding material or molding sand. So flowability, what is flowability? Flowability is the ability of the molding sand to get compacted to uniform density. So what is flowability? It is the ability of the molding sand to get compacted to uniform density. Now this flowability increases as the clay and water content increases. So as the clay and water content increases, the flowability also increases. That is our first property, that is flowability. Next is grain strength. What is grain strength? Grain strength is the strength of sand in moist condition. So the strength in moist state is known as grain strength, and this grain strength help in making and handling of the mold. So the mold making completely depends on the grain strength. So this flowability test of the molding sand can be done. Similarly, grain strength test can be done. So these are the mechanical properties of the sand, and these properties can be tested very easily, but the tests are not in the scope of our syllabus. So we will confine to the name of this property, and what is the effect of these properties, that we will know only. So now hot strength. What is hot strength? Hot strength is nothing but it is the strength at elevated temperature, that means at higher temperature the strength is known as hot strength. So due to if there is absence of adequate hot strength at that time, what happens at that time? There may be enlargement of the casting, cracking or breaking of the mold. So what happens when the molten metal is poured into the mold? The molten metal will be in very high temperature, okay, because it is molten, because the metals itself has very high melting point. So as the metal has high melting point, So whenever the molten metal is poured into the cavity, at that time in the cavity very huge temperature rise will occur, and that temperature rise will try to break or try to cause enlargement or break the mold. But if there is adequate hot strength in the molding sand, this cracking or breaking won't occur. Okay, so now this is about hot strength. Now there is another type, there is some other properties. Next is your dry strength. So the molding material or molding sand should have adequate dry strength. So what is dry strength? It is the dry condition strength of the molding sand. That means the strength of the dry sand is known as dry strength. That means in the sand the moisture content is less, or there is no moisture content, at that time the strength of the sand is known as dry strength. And dry strength is directly related to grain size, binder and water content. So this dry strength is completely directly related to grain size, binder and water content. Remember one thing, remember or understand one thing, that dry strength, dry sand and grain sand. Okay, first the sand we are using, see the transformation. First we are having heap sand. That heap sand is placed in a heap. From the heap, by using sieve, we just take the finer sand. And when we take the finer sand, that sand are known as sharp sand or loose sand. Sharp sand or loose sand. So from heap sand, we divide the sharp or loose sand. That means those sand which has no bonding. After that, we mix this loose sand or sharp sand along with water, binder and clay. And by making this, we make green sand. Now we left this green sand mold for some time to dry, for drying of this mold. And by drying this mold, we get dry sand mold. So remember this thing, that how the sand is changed in the course of casting. So first there is heap sand, then there is sharp sand, then there is green sand, and then the sand mold will be dry sand mold. And at the dry sand condition, what happens? At the dry condition, our molding of our mold, at the dry condition the strength should be there so that it can resist the mold pouring of the molten metal. Okay, now refractoriness, this is very important property. Refractoriness means it is the ability of the molding sand to withstand high temperature without failure. So refractoriness is completely related to your hot strength. Okay, now these are more or less same term. So refractoriness means the ability to resist high temperature without failure. So the molding sand should have the property of refractoriness. And next, adhesiveness. Adhesiveness means there is two type of force or two type of attraction in between the material. First one is cohesive attraction. Cohesive means the attraction between same particle. That means sand particle will attract to another sand particle. That is your cohesiveness. And adhesiveness, when the adhesiveness means the sand particle will attract the molten metal or attract the wall of the mold cavity, or wall of the molten metal. Or sand particle will stick to the wall of the mold box. That is called adhesiveness. So adhesive means sand particle will attract the metal in the wall of the mold box. That is called adhesiveness. So in the moldings and the adhesive along with cohesiveness, adhesiveness is another very important property. So now there is fineness. So fineness means finer the sand mold, finer sand mold resist metal penetration and produce soft smooth casting surface. So that's why we need fineness, and it can maintain by using mold coating on highly permeable mold cavity wall. So there we need permeability also, we need fineness also. Permeability means due to permeability there is gap between the sand cavity sand particles, and that in that gap there is a chance that molten metal can enter, and that could distort our desired shape. Now if we need a fine surface finish, then at the mold wall there should be some coating should be there, so some fine coating should be there, so that the molten metal cannot enter the mold cavity. But there is some permeability too. There should be some permeability too. And that permeability can be given by using vent wire. So by using vent wire, that gas that is formed inside the mold cavity can go out. So that should be there. Next is bench life. Bench life is the ability of the molding sand to retain its property during storage or while standing. That means the bench life is nothing but if we keep that mold for some certain amount of time, the mold should be like that, or it should retain its property. That is called bench life. Expansion coefficient. So molding sand should have very low expansion coefficient or no thermal expansion coefficient, because if there is thermal expansion coefficient, what will occur? The mold enlargement can occur, and due to mold enlargement, the mold can break very easily. So that should not be there. So there are various additives used in the molding sand. Those are first facing material, as we said that in the face. Or in the facing material means those materials which came into direct contact with the molten metal. There we have to use different materials so to get a smoother and cleaner surface and to easy peeling of sand from the casting surface during shake out. So the example of the facing materials are sea coal, pitch and asphalt, graphite, coke and silica floor. And similarly there is cushion materials mainly these cushion materials mainly burns when the molten metal is poured to and give rise to the space for accommodating the expansion of the silica sand at the surface of the mold cavity. So that means that small thermal expansion that can be possible, and those thermal expansion, that possible thermal expansion can be treated by using these cushion materials. For example, wood floor, cereal hulls and cellulose, these are our cushion materials. So thank you for being here, and if you have any problem, you may ask in the live class. Hope you enjoy this lecture. Thank you.